Ord'nance Survey by William Beaumont, read by Nick Gisburne. I'm ringing up my curtain upon an ancient scene, as when redcoats came to Burton to measure land for Queen. They turned up in fine weather one summer out at Blue, a score altogether, and one in charge at crew. A sergeant, such a pusher, and just as full a swank as Emperor of Russia or boss at Penny Bank. So every neat in local, yon sergeant could be seen, impressing all at locals with his paper from the Queen. Her Majesty had sent him for to measure up her land, and to that end she had sent him wi' a paper from her hand. Victoria's bit of vellum, a big red seal it bore, and every neat it tell him, as tall as knee to fore, how at a palace pageant Her Majesty had said, "Stand forth, that splendid sergeant," and forward he were led. Her Majesty confided, "Our maps must all be true, and so I have decided to give the task to you. This gives you right of entry to every man's estate, the yeomanry, the gentry, the humble, and the great." So one bright June morning, yon redcoats in a swarm, without a word of warning, descended on Slant Farm. Nat tenant, Billy Pogson, he waved a warning stick.
"Clear off, or I'll set dogs on,"
he shouted double quick. But sergeant showed his permit, and said, "We're here to stay. This document, old hermit, gives us the right of way." Its paragraphs Billy fingered with military zeal, and lovingly he lingered upon its royal seal.
"Oh, all right,"
said Billy, humbled by what had been revealed.
"But just take care," he grumbled. "Keep out at bottom field,"
said sergeant, quite unheedful.
"We'll go where we think fit, and if we find it needful, we'll tramp all over it."
Well, 20 minutes later, sergeant Cock-a-Hoop, observed by one spectator, led in his loyal troop. They marched in fine and dandy, so splendid to be seen, with chains and tackle ready for measure land for Queen. Then Farmer Pogson, viewing from t'other side at wall,
"Thought there'll be trouble brewing when old Shylock sees them all."
Bad-tempered Shylock laid there, dozing in long grass, beneath the old elm trees, till he heard yon redcoats pass. It made old Billy shiver, that first tremendous roar, for surely no bull had ever seen so much red before. He raised up on his forelegs and let forth a second cry, at which 20 legs across the field did fly. Now by my simple schooling, beyond a shadow of a doubt, there's no gainsaying ruling, first an in is last an out. And wherefore when they started, sergeant were at their head, now they'd all departed, he were at the back instead. Still buttoned up and buckled, he puffed away at rear, and Farmer Pogson chuckled and gave hearty cheer as he watched the sergeant caper and like a rabbit run, and yelled to him, "The paper! Show him the paper, mon!"